Hi everybody, good evening and a very warm welcome along to eLECt. For those of you who don't know me, my name is Simon Hessett and I'm one of the organisers of eLECt from the congregation of Labrettes Church. eLECt is our monthly evening service which usually features some food and drink which we would eat together before worshipping together with music provided by a small band and we would normally have a reflection by a guest speaker every month as well. Well, we may have to slightly curtail some of that this month. I have some snippets of music by the eLECt band which we'll be listening to as we worship together, and I hope you'll enjoy that. One feature which I won't be able to bring this evening is the interactive prayer of intercession. Now you may be wondering why, and it's because I've had to cheat, I'm afraid to say. It's actually Saturday afternoon as I record this, and I hope you won't be offended, but we've had too many technical challenges and too many health and safety challenges to bring this to you live. So instead of that, what I thought we could do is to join the 7 o'clock call for Christian unity in prayer as we join with other Christians across the land to pray together the same words. And also if we can do this to place a candle in our windows at the same time. Now, I've got a battery powered candle, so I possibly have cheated again, and I'm going to use that. There'll be an opportunity for you to go and gather one later in the service, and I'll tell you when the time is, and we will say the words of that prayer together instead of our usual interactive prayers of intercession. Now, a little bit more about eLECt if you're unfamiliar with it. And if you have a look at the screen just now, it will tell you that you'll find some of our music, if you're interested in it, on Spotify. We have a Spotify playlist which has almost all of eLECt's songbook in it. It's simply called eLECt. So if you like the music you're hearing this evening, and you might like to hear it again by its original artist, then have a search for eLECt, and you'll turn up a playlist there with some of the stuff that we perform on a Sunday evening with the band usually. And if you're enjoying eLECt this evening and you'd like to stay in touch with us for future services, then please go onto our Facebook page, which is called eLECt Larbert, and give us a like, and you'll notice that we publish each of our services as events, which you can join up to, or indeed watch us live online if you like in the future, although we'd love it if you come along when things are back to normal and we're able to eat and drink together before coming into the church and worshipping together as well. So that's called eLECt Larbert and it's on Facebook. This is our order of service for today. You can see that we have four pieces of music by the eLECt band, and we're going to finish with Psalm 130 from our friends at Getty Music, who have very kindly lifted their restrictions on showing their videos online during the current crisis. We'll have a prayer of approach together, and I'll be talking about stillness and silence for our talk today. And then, as I said, at 7 o'clock, we'll pray together with other Christians across the land. Now, I think we should begin, and so we'll pass over, and I hope you'll join in singing along. I'll pass over to the eLECt band, who are going to perform King of Kings, Majesty.
Thank you.
Well, let's take a moment now to pray together. As I pray, I'm going to put the words on the screen in case you'd like to join in. And at the end of the prayer, we're going to say the Lord's Prayer together as well. So let's pray. Father God, we thank you for this time to think about you and what you are trying to say to us through the quiet and through the stillness. In the stillness, some of us may feel happy, others may feel unsettled. We pray that however we find ourselves, we can let go and just focus on you. Lord God, it is difficult to imagine that we are gathered together as your family in times when we are not physically together. But we know that you promised that when two or three are gathered, you are there. And we know that is true where we are gathered together in church, or whether we are at home and simply gathered in spirit. So with that thought, we say together the words that Jesus taught us to pray, knowing that our brothers and sisters are saying the same words at the same time, and that this is more important than being physically together. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Well, let's sing together again as we hear from the eLECt band singing, Knowing You, Jesus.
Thank you.
Well, it's time for our reflection now, which today is called Stillness and Silence. And in order to bring that to you, I'm afraid it's time for the old glasses to go on. These days, the eyes are not that good at reading small print, and my reflection is printed out just under the camera ahead of me. I don't know about you, but I would say that one of the most noticeable side effects of the situation that we find ourselves in just now is the abundance of peace and quiet, particularly in the evenings and at night time. So many sounds that provide the ambient soundtrack to our lives are simply not there or happen a lot less. Living beside a railway station, I can tell you there's a lot less trains passing through both during the day and the night. The sound of children playing on the streets outside and in the park just down the road from me is absent, and there's noticeably less traffic on the road outside. Few planes fly over anymore, and the sound of neighbours chatting outside is also gone. All of this results in the same thing, a quality that's normally missing from our day-to-day lives: silence. Now, I was brought up in the rural Borders region, where silence wasn't that hard to come by. Hours would pass at night time, where I could lie awake in bed and hear absolutely nothing. There were places that you could go walking and again find utter silence. I cannot tell you how much I love silence. But I also know that silence is a thing that can scare many of us. Maybe those of us who were brought up in more urban environments like the audible pulse of daily life. Small children often find some noise and bustle reassuring too. So when it suddenly isn't there anymore, there's a temptation to panic and to make some noise to fill the space, perhaps by turning on the radio or television or finding some other distraction. I do wonder though if we're quick to make some noise when a quiet interlude presents itself, and in doing that we miss an important opportunity to just be still and contemplate God, and perhaps even listen for his voice. In fact, I go as far as to ask you, just how often have you slowed down in your life and just listened to the sound of silence? Could we honestly say that we find such peace in an average week of our busy lives? In the Bible, the words "be still" appear in two Psalms as an instruction to the reader. The first of those is Psalm 37, which urges us to be still before the Lord and wait patiently for him. This is a psalm which asks us to step away from the pace of the world around us and to reject its empty ambition and wickedness. Instead of these things, it tells us that we should use the quiet and still to pray and to come before God. The second psalm is perhaps the more famous of the two, Psalm 46, which tells us to be still and know that I am God. This psalm asks us to use God as a safe place to hide when the storms of the world rage all around us. Instead, it asks us to turn our attention to God and to find refuge in Him alone. I don't think in my life that I could ever say I've experienced God anywhere that was bustling with noise. Wherever God has indeed popped up to say something to me, I can tell you it's always been somewhere quiet, and I've always been still, or indeed stilled, by God's presence. Even so, in busy cities where you can't usually even hear yourself think. I don't doubt that God tries to speak to us a lot more than the few times we actually hear His voice. But if we're honest about it, how often are we actually listening? In the days after Jesus' crucifixion, John's Gospel tells us that the disciples were afraid and they hid from the authorities. In the same way that we are now, they sought shelter, hiding away in a house with a locked door, fearful for their lives. John writes of Jesus first appearing to the disciples in the still of that house. The first words that Jesus has for them are, "Peace be with you." Later on, Simon Peter announces to the other disciples that he is going fishing. Now, of course, I'm not suggesting that you all go and do that, of course, but I did wonder why he would choose to go fishing of all things. Was he hungry? Was this a sign that he wanted to go back to his profession from before that time that Jesus had called him? Or perhaps he was just seeking out silence. Jesus himself would often seek silence out to pray, retiring to a nearby place by himself after teaching. Luke reminds us of this in his Gospel, in chapter 5, verses 15 and 16, where he writes the words, "But the news about Jesus spread all the more widely, and crowds of people came to hear him and be healed from their diseases. But he would go away to lonely places where he prayed." And this tradition of finding solitude for prayer and to seek closeness to God goes right the way back to the story of Moses. Finally, another place in the Bible where we find the word "be still" is in Mark's Gospel, where we hear the story of Jesus stilling the storm. We are told that a great windstorm arose whilst Jesus and his disciples were sailing across the Sea of Galilee. Now, these windstorms are very well known, still are in fact very well known, in that area of the world. And you have to believe that their boat was in real and imminent danger. The waves were crashing over the sides and the boat had begun to sink. But all through this, Jesus was still. He slept and he didn't worry. When the disciples woke him in panic, he rebuked the wind and he said to the sea, "Peace, be still." And it was. Well, it goes without saying that there is a pretty wild storm blowing in the world just now. Maybe in these weeks, the sea represents the awful things that are happening round about us, or instead, maybe in fact represents us, our raging and unsettled mood. But we need to be still, and we need to wait for God, and we need to be still, and we need to know that He is God. And if we can't do that, perhaps we should pray for Jesus to calm us with the words he used on the sea, "Peace, be still," and then we'll know. So here's a challenge for you. Out of all of the adversity that we find ourselves in just now, try to find a few minutes where you can be alone in the silence. Don't give in to the temptation to move around or to make some noise or turn the radio on. Just sit down or lie down and see how still you can be. Focus on the silence instead of the noise and just let it all wash over you. See if you can sense in it God's presence and peace, and maybe even his voice speaking to you from the stillness. For I guarantee to you that you're much more likely to hear him there in the quiet than you ever are in the bustle of our normal world. Amen. Well, now we've completed our reflection, I'd like to invite you to, if you wish to join in with lighting a candle and the prayer that will follow with your fellow Christians around the country, to go and see if you can find a candle and something to light it with, or maybe even better still or safer, a battery-powered candle like mine here. And in just a moment after we've heard the next song, what we'll do is we'll light those together and I'll explain a little bit more about why we're doing that, and then we'll read the prayer together from the screen. So our next song we're going to hear though is from the eLECt band again, performing Psalm 62.
Thank you.
Now, I hope that musical interlude gave you long enough to go and locate a candle if you wish to join in with putting a candle in your window as we do the joint prayer of intercession together. And let's do that now if you wish to join in. I've got my little battery-powered candle here and a little candle holder that Matthew made, my son Matthew, that is, earlier on. So I'm just going to switch that on now. Maybe you'd like to light your candle, and I'll pop that in there. There we go. It's more impressive when it's dark, I must admit, and it's not too dark being 7 o'clock in April in Scotland, unfortunately. But I'm going to just pop it on the window across there behind me, and I hope that that is visible to you still at home. Now, you might be wondering, whilst you're lighting your candles, why we're doing this. And the reason is that 13 Christian churches and organisations across Scotland, including the Church of Scotland, are going to be taking part in this joint prayer together. The Right Reverend Colin Sinclair, who's our current moderator, said that prayer has become increasingly a valued time for Christians. As we pause to pray, conscious that many others will be sharing the same prayer at the same time, it helps to create a sense of community when we're isolated through lockdown. South of the border, churches together in England will also be praying with us on Sunday at 7 o'clock, and they'll be using the social media hashtag Prayers of Hope to share the message on social media, which you're invited to join as well. All the churches have issued a letter this week with the prayer, and this is what the letter says. As we find ourselves living through a renewed phase of lockdown, we see in the Gospel of John, chapter 20, verses 19 to 23, that in part the experience of the disciples, even on the day of the resurrection, was one in which they found themselves locked in and behind closed doors. Their experience of lockdown was interrupted by the presence of Jesus as he came and stood among them. He speaks into the depths of their fears and their anxieties. Peace be with you. We hear those words and we know they speak to us. We listen again for what he will say, and discover that Jesus simply repeats himself, "Peace be with you." As we still ourselves, we hear those words of peace spoken, and we sense that they are spoken to us and all who long to hear a word that heals and reassures. Peace be with you. Well, as we pray together, I'm going to put the words of the prayer on the screen so you can read them aloud if you want to take part as well. So let's pray. Living God, speak into the depths of our experience. Speak the word that stills our fears and calms our anxieties. Peace be with you. Speak your word to the lonely and to the broken, to the bereaved and to those whose world has crumbled. Peace be with you. Faithful God, speak to us behind locked doors as we remember others who risk their own safety in order to serve others. Peace be with them. Carers and nurses, doctors and ambulance drivers, delivery drivers and shop assistants, peace be with them. God, who inspires hope, speak to us in the present, and speak to us of the future. For though the doors are locked, in time they shall be open. Peace shall be renewed. For those who lead the life of our nation, our Queen Elizabeth, First Minister and Prime Minister, and all who shape our common life, for us all, peace shall be renewed. God, whose name is love, and whose gift is love, open our hearts to know you and to love you. To love you and to love our neighbour, and as we do, to hear again, peace be with you. May we find our strength in you, and hear again, peace be with you. Amen. Well, our closing song by the eLECt band, but not entirely our closing song, as you'll see in a few minutes, is one which reminds us of the light in Jesus. Lord, the light of your love is shining. Shine, Jesus, shine. Thing I have to do is just to pray that the grace and peace of the Lord Jesus Christ be with you all now and forevermore. Amen. We leave you tonight with a video provided by our friends at Getty Music of their recent redoing of Psalm 130. I hope you enjoy it. Good night.
of the depths I cry to you. In darkest places I will call. Incline your ear to me anew and hear my cry for mercy, Lord. Were you to count my sinful ways, how could I come before your throne? Yet full forgiveness meets my gaze. I stand redeemed by grace alone. I will.